Inside this Madrid hospital are 100 COVID-19 patients. Spain may be just a week or so behind Italy. Infections accelerating, up by almost 1,000 on yesterday. The medics on the front line starting to struggle.
My feeling is we should be one step ahead of this crisis instead of two steps behind. People working here, in this moment, they don't have enough protective equipment, so more health workers are facing a risk of falling ill.
And falling ill too, the lady in black, kissing Spain's queen last week. She's a government minister, but it's now known she's infected. So the queen and Spain's king, who met Emmanuel Macron yesterday, have also had to be tested. And Spain's prime minister is keeping his distance. Journalists today forced to ask questions by video link from his car park. He's called for social discipline, but not shutdowns.
And this is one of the worst affected areas around Madrid. But what strikes you when you're here is how many people are out on the streets. Spain's government is issuing warnings, but unlike Italy, it's not yet shutting down areas like this.
This is an infection hotspot, but tour groups of pensioners at high risk have still been coming. The bars and restaurants open.
The people here doesn't care. In the bars, taking the beers, the cinema. In one region, all closed. In another region, all open. It's not normal. So everybody, 2 weeks in house. And we can cut the problem.
Here, we used to have the thermometers.
Some are scared. The local pharmacist is out of thermometers.
As you can see, they are empty right now.
And down to his last box of sanitizer.
This is all you have.
Yeah.
Just one delivery. And the next one is coming?
we don't know.
Don't know when.
Outside, we found these British language students who've all just booked flights home.
Us two are going tomorrow, you're going Saturday,
Sunday.
Monday.
Because of the virus?
Yeah.
Well, and because they cancel all their classes.
So is Spain doing too little, too late? The fear this place could, like parts of Italy, be overburdened in just a few days' time. Damian Grammaticus, BBC News, Madrid.